Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel Nautical Series. This is the part 2 of video latitude and longitude. Now the next topic is dilat and delong. First we'll see dilat, that means difference between the latitude. Explain this, I'll draw a diagram again. This is the equator. Zero degree. Let this be the latitude. This be the another latitude. Let it be A. Let it be B. So dilat means difference between the latitude. The difference between the latitude. This is called as dilat. This is A, this is B. Let us consider this is 20 degree north. Let us consider this is 30 degree north. Let us consider. So the difference between these two latitude is 10 degree. So the difference is 10 degree. Now we have to see whether it is north or south. If a vessel is going from A to B, that is A to B means the vessel is going like this. The difference will be, the dilat will be 10 degree north. And now consider the vessel is going from B to A. That means B to A. So the dilat will be 10 degree south. Because the heading, the ship is going towards the south. Still it has not crosses the equator, it has not gone beyond the equator, but the dilat value it will take, that is south, 10 degree south. So it depends whether the vessel is going towards the north or towards the south. Dilat is named north or south according to the direction from first place to the second place. Similarly, in south hemisphere, let these be the two latitude. This is 30 degree south. This is 60 degree south. The difference between it is, dilat is 30 degree. We have to see whether north or south. That depends upon the vessel, which direction it is going. Here the difference of latitude was 10 degree. So let it be A dash and B dash. If the vessel is going from A to B, then dilat will be 30 degree north because the ship is heading towards the north. At the same time, if the vessel is going from B dash to A dash, dilat will be 30 degree south. Next is delong, that is difference between the longitude. Again, we will draw the diagram. This is the equator, north, south. Let it be the prime meridian. The value is 000 degree equator. This is prime meridian. I'll write it as PM. So let us consider any longitude, let it be here. So d long is difference between the longitude. The another longitude will take it here. Let the value of this d long be 50 degree. Let this be as 70 degree west. This is east. This is west. So d long means difference between a longitude. Difference between longitude, this longitude and this longitude is 50 degree. Difference between this longitude and this longitude is 70 degree. And difference between this longitude and this longitude is 20 degree. So we'll see how we will name that, whether it is east or west. Let this be point A, let this be point B. So d long, if the vessel is going from A to B, then d long will be 20 degree east. If the vessel is going from B to A, B dash, or from B dash to A dash, from B dash to A dash, then the D long value will be 20 degree west. If you see that D long A to B, if we go A to B, it is 20 degree east. Perhaps we are in the western hemisphere. We have not crossed the prime meridian, but still we are acting 20 degree east, because it does not depend upon which hemisphere we are in. Rather, it depends upon the heading we are going to. That means the direction we are going to. Here we are going towards the east. So we will write d long as east. If we go from B dash to A dash, we are heading towards west. So we will write it as 20 degree west. So if we cross the 180 degree meridian, there the scenarios are different. So we'll talk what name we'll give to the D long if we cross 180 degree meridian in some other video. For the next video, we'll be looking for compass points and some other nautical terms. So see you guys in the next video.